Welcome to Mycronic here at Productronica. Delighted to be joined by Clemens Jorgen. Lovely to see you again, Clemens.
Hi, Trevor. Welcome here at the Mycronic booth.
Yes, so a couple of really interesting products this week. You've got a brand new platform behind us, which is the Mycronic A40 DX. This is the successor to the Mycronic 300.
Yes, exactly, Trevor.
So tell me what makes it different, because from the outside, it looks pretty much the same.
Yes, exactly. So this is in fact a new machine under the same hood.
Okay.
So what we have done, we have developed a new high-speed head, which is the MX7. And you know, the high-speed placement head is the heartbeat of the machine.
Of course.
And the new head makes the machine running 48% faster in throughput than the previous version.
Wow.
And this is a lot, yeah, because the new high-speed head has 7 different nozzles. They can move independently. And the real big change is here that these high-speed head can cover more than 98% of all typically used components in the pick and placement process. So there is rarely the need for the meters, which is a single pit head.
I see. So basically, what you had before was like a chip shooter configuration, and then the meters basically took care of odd form or anything a little bit bigger. But you've expanded that by using the new head to cover a much wider range of your components.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah. So there's almost no need anymore for the single pick. That means the high-speed head, the new MX7, can cover the majority of products. But when you change the high-speed head in a machine, that means you need to redo almost everything. So it's a complete brand new software behind.
Yeah.
That means you see under the same hood, in fact, a complete new machine. Redoing all the software after redoing all the system behind to make the new high-speed head running so fast, we have also introduced a new user interface, a graphic user interface.
Okay.
Yeah? So there's a complete new software also now how the operator can run the machine, because we have recognized here that new operators want to run machines in a new way, and this is when they requested the GUI.
Okay.
But we have done it in a way that we can still keep the old software, but also use the new software. And this new user interface is not just another way to operate the machine. We try to support the operator in the production flow. That means the user interface really supports him in the whole way how he runs the machine.
So that has also been paired with your improvements on the printing side, because you've got a zero defect solution on the other side of the booth there, which comprises stencil printer, which I'm surprised to see you having, plus of course your famous jet printer next to your SPI system. So you're using it in a closed loop configuration. Can you explain to our viewers a little bit more about how that works?
Because the machine is now so fast, when you for example now connect two A40s, they are now as fast as previously three machines.
Right, right.
But with this fast machine now, we were in the need to have also a faster solder paste process.
Right.
This is why we added a screen printer.
I see, I see.
But it wouldn't be too easy just to add a screen printer, so therefore we thought, how can we improve the screen print process? Because we both know, as everybody knows, the majority of concerns and issues appear and happen in the solder paste deposition process.
Absolutely. I mean, the famous metric everybody uses is 60 to 70% of the defects come from the printer. But of course, the vast majority of these defects are missing paste or insufficient paste.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you're going to top up with the jet printer.
Yes. And what we did then was that we said, we need to bring a screen printer into the portfolio to keep up the speed when needed, but combine the screen printer with our SPI capabilities and the jet printer and make it a zero defect printing solution.
Okay.
That means this, the pattern of the screen printer can be checked with the SPI, and when there's any paste missing, a dot missing, the jet printer can add on. Yeah? So there's the closed loop functionality between screen printer, SPI and jet printer to have a perfect solder paste pattern for our customers.
Absolutely, yeah, that's very impressive. So, I mean, putting that together with a couple of A40s, which, by the way, will reduce the overall footprint on the line, because if you're if that takes the equivalent of three machines, then it's obviously going to reduce the footprint. And then controlling all of that, we're going to be looking at the MyProLink. So let's take a walk over and have a look at how it's all connected together. So Clemens, we've had a really good look at the hardware. We've had a look at the zero defect solution. We've looked at the A40 pick and place with the new GUI and the new head. But it's all about software at the end of the day.
Yes.
So exactly. We've got a fantastic graphic here behind us that shows the software configuration of the MyProLink and how that works. So can you explain how what we're looking at here?
Yes, exactly. So the hardware is essential. So we have renewed now the pick and place. We renewed now the high-speed head. We changed the GUI. We optimized process flow. But we need to look at the entire process flow of the pick and place process. It starts from material handling, goes over screen printing, SPI, jet printing, pick and place, AOI to make sure that we have a perfect throughput and a perfect quality.
Yep.
But this has to be connected together. This is why we have the closed loop on the printing side.
Yes.
This is why we connect the SPI with the AOI via the MyProLink to process control.
Mm-hmm.
But we also have introduced our MyProConnect, which is in fact the CFX equivalent, yeah.
Okay, so this is the MyProConnect, which is the CFX link up to the ERP and the MES system.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So, you know, customers come with proprietary solutions, they come with standard ERP, MES solutions, and we want to be flexible. That means we have here the interface, and they can connect into their factory surrounding our machines.
Right, yeah. Okay. And the other thing I noticed, which of course is a given, is that each of these machines is joined together using the Hermes line automation solution here.
Yes, so yeah. We are now Hermes compliant on the whole portfolio. They are all connected to each other, and that means we also fulfill your industry standards.
Yes, excellent. Okay, so it's so important because then being able to do this, you can then extract all the data from all of these machines and processes up into the MES you know, for traceability and for trend analysis and this type of thing.
Yes, so yeah. Because process control means data control, you need to collect data for track and tracing. And also now when on the AOI, we introduce the AI tools to make the AOI even more precise, even more faster, even more reliable. All this data which we create here, which we use, goes into the data control to make it a controlled process for our customers.
Right, excellent. Well, it's an impressive system. It keeps continually evolving.
Yeah, thank you.
And
thank you.
So congratulations on especially the sort of defect system. I really like that, the zero defect. And the new head, of course, with a 48% speed increase. I mean, that is quite significant.
Tangible number, significant number, and customers appreciate that.
Yeah, love it. So thank you for showing that to us today, Clemens, and we'll look forward to seeing you again in the future.
Thanks for being with us, Trevor.